Welcome to the Learning Academy. In education today, data is king. Data is constantly being collected for students and staff. So why wouldn't it be available for the usage of your student tools? After all, how will you know if students are using the tools at all, and are they effectively using the tools? That's why with all Don Johnston Universal Learning Supports, data is collected by the individual student. To do so, today we're looking at CoWriter. So I've logged in at CoWriter.com and I'm going to click View Reports. As this page loads, you'll notice that I can look at data a couple of different ways. I have the ability to look at all of the students that I'm using CoWriter with. And if I'm using Google Classroom, I also have the ability to pull my CoWriter data via that Google Classroom. If your district is a Google district and has organizational units set up through the Google Admin Console, data can also be pulled by any Google OUs that are established. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and click on All Students, and I will see the data for each of the students that I am working with that have been assigned CoWriter. When this page loads, you'll see that I'm going to see cumulative data for the group. So as my group, my students have used CoWriter to write 2.5 million words or just over. And over on the side, I have all of my students. If I click on my student's name, I will see when they were assigned CoWriter. This is going to be especially important for state assessment testing, as oftentimes we have to prove that the student has had access to the instructional accommodation for a period of time in order to have it as an allowable accommodation. I'll see quantitative data, so how much is the student using the tool, and then I will also see qualitative data down below. Not only is it important that students are using the accommodations that you've given them, but we also need to monitor and collect data as to how effective those tools are in helping students meet the rigor of college and career readiness. So this quantitative data is super important because it shows that we're using the tool, but even more important is that qualitative data. So how good are the words that the student is using the tool to use? So here, if I look at academic words and I click on more info, that will actually break down my academic words. Those are covered in a variety of sublists. Here I see list of words that the student has actually used here. Words that have not been used that are on that subset. So I immediately see a vocabulary lesson coming. In addition to academic vocabulary, you also have data collected on transitional words and phrases, which is really important because it has the tendency to raise state assessment scores. And then these important words as well. If you want more info, click on more info. This data is super important because not only does it let administrators know that the money that they have invested is actually being used and is seeing results, as the related services providers, you know that students are actually using the tools that you have assigned to them as part of their IEP. You have the ability to know which students in which classrooms are using the tools. And this is also a great way to motivate students to continue to see this. So I encourage you to print out this data periodically or download it for safekeeping, and you always have that data available there. This data and increased usage over time will increase confidence and will only lead to more usage. With more usage, you'll also see additional academic outcomes as well.